Bring. Bring. Did I get my numbers correct? Did I get my numbers correct on the calculator? Did I get... Oh, what the fuck am I even doing? If my math is correct, or if the numbers are correct, we have seen a total, and I did the numbers, based on the actual fact of the matter, that under the Moron Healey-Kim Dumbass government here in Massachusetts, that has been nothing but a record of failure and a record of losing, and practically makes me embarrassed to be from this state, because this state is such an unfortunate embarrassment and a complete fucking train wreck and a shipwreck under this government. But if I did the numbers correctly, spending has been increased in the second consecutive year of Maura Healey's term in office of 7.4%. 4.1% increase in 2023 and another 3.3% increase this year. If you add up the numbers, that's a 7.4% increase in Maura Healey's 2 years of being in office. This is her second consecutive year, and we're already seeing an increase in spending. Now, do the Democrats, the current day Democrat politicians, do they have any ideology beyond tax and spend? Do they really? I'm not too sure. I don't think they do. Actually, I answered that question for myself. They simply just don't. Welcome to the Massachusetts Report, everybody. I'm your host, Zach the Celtics Guy. A little bit of satire in the beginning, of course, as you see, because I love sarcasm. I love doing sarcasm and some humor slapped on top of it. Some satirical humor slapped onto my coverage of domestic and global politics and world affairs in general. So, if I did the numbers correct, and literally the numbers are literally right here in black and white, it says here, according to an article, Maura Healey's first budget theme is spending increases. Maura Healey outlined her $55.5 billion budget, which is aimed, oh yeah, it's really making it more affordable and climate friendly, right? Uh-huh, yeah, sure, okay. A 4.1% increase over the current year's budget. So, in Charlie Baker's last year in office, which I wish he was still in office, because if he was, we wouldn't be in this fucking mess that we're in. A 4.1% increase over the current year's budget. So that's a 4.1% increase in that 1 year alone. Okay. And then, if we look at the numbers here, according to the other one, the proposal sets for debate in 2 weeks, this is on April 10th of this year, would increase spending by about $1.9 billion, or a 3.3% increase. So, if you add the numbers up, Maura Healey has increased spending by $57 billion in total. My money, everybody's taxes in this state, every taxpayer, you know, the ones that haven't been driven out by Maura Healey's record of failure yet, at least not yet. That's $57.4 billion. Your money, if you're here in Massachusetts like me, your money, my parents' money, everybody else's money that lives in this state. So, is that a problem to increase spending like that? And the answer is yes. Of course it is, because that's spending more money than is in the treasury. That's the reason why we have a structural deficit. That's the reason why we have such an inhospitable business climate that has deteriorated significantly since Maura Healey took office. That is the exact reason why we're in the current state that we're in, and there's nothing good that Maura Healey has done. I cannot think of one positive thing that this idiot has done since she's taken office. I cannot think of one thing. There is not one positive thing that her or Kim Dumbass have done that has been positive for Massachusetts. That hasn't. She hasn't done anything effective except drive jobs and businesses out of the state and drive taxpayers out of the state at an alarming rate. I haven't seen anything else that's been positive. Have you? If you live in Massachusetts, have you seen anything positive by Maura Healey's so-called progressive agenda? Have you seen that? Have you seen that? Oh, yeah, by the way, did you know that she's going to be spending $1 billion of your money and my money on sanctuary state policies? That, which is literally just Democrats smuggling in migrants from their port of origin to literally make political brownie points about how we're inclusive and we're the good ones here. And as I've said before, I've always acknowledged how destructive U.S. foreign policy is in Latin America, in the Middle East, and beyond. Oh, trust me, I acknowledge that 100%. Oh, I acknowledge that 100%. But you see how the Democrats are treating this situation. So yeah, Maura Healey's is going to use $1 billion of that on her failed sanctuary state policies. So, what's the solution to a $57.4 billion increase in spending since she's been in office? What's the solution to that? How can we contend to a budget like that that isn't doing anything to make what is it doing to make anything better in this state? What is it doing? What is it doing to bring more dollars to our local communities? What is it doing for us? I can't think of anything. There is nothing, because there's nothing good. Because there isn't anything good. Because this state is in a complete and utter mess. It is in a structural deficit, and the economy is a mess. And the last thing that you want to do in hard economic times for this state and way beyond our state's borders, in order to solve the problem with hard economic times, what do Democrats do? What do the Democrat Party politicians do? What do? They just tax you more. That they tax people, particularly at the lower end of the income scale, the most. And they increase spending. More money that's going into the treasury. More money that is going into our state's treasury is being spent by Maura Healey and Kim Dumbass. Moron Healey and Kim Dumbass. There is a solution to this. There is a big solution to this problem. And you know, the number one thing that we need to do is, first of all, I mean, we need to reduce taxes. I mean, that's a given. And the other thing is, we got to trim spending. We got to trim government spending. Because, I mean, the Moron Healey Kim Dumbass regime in this state has increased spending by $57.4 billion, up 7.4%. I think that spending needs to be reduced in a responsible way. And trust me, I would love to be in there because I would love to be in Beacon Hill. Oh, man. I would love it so much, man. Oh, I would just love it so much. I'd love it so much to trim spending and to tell these partisan Democrats to sit the hell down and stop spending everybody's damn money. That's what I would do. Well, I mean, the first thing I would do if I get into office, first thing I would do is I'd cut spending. I would cut spending here in Massachusetts. That's what I would do. Because this government here in this state has increased spending by 7.4%. I would cut that spending. I would literally do it with executive order. That's how ridiculous it is. That's how ridiculous that spending has gotten in this state. So I would cut spending. I would cut spending. I would do it 100%. I would literally have, I would pass executive order. I would pass executive order to cut spending in the state within my first 90 days in office. I would do it. And then I would roll out real tax relief for small and entrepreneurial businesses and middle class taxpayers in the state. Oh, I would. I would literally roll that up. I would absolutely roll that up because they have to go along with that. Because that is exactly what I would do. Every single one of Maura Healey's tax policies and economic policies have hit people at the lower end of the income scale the most. And that's what I would focus on, and that's what needs to be focused on. And that's what the next governor needs to do. That's what the next governor needs to do before Maura Healey bankrupts what is left of this state. So no, the reality of the situation is government spending has to be done responsibly. And it literally needs to be done in a responsible way and in a balanced way. It is not done in a balanced way. What is balanced about this? Can anyone explain to me what is so balanced about this? Can you tell me? Because I certainly can't. I most certainly can't. I don't know what the hell is balanced here. What's a balanced budget again? Oh, I don't know, man. I most certainly don't know. Oh, I most certainly don't know. I certainly don't know. Yeah, I don't know. There's nothing, that's what. Fucking nothing, that's what. There's nothing. Nothing responsible is going on. And you literally see it, too. And you just look at that one local chain restaurant in Everett, Massachusetts that relocated to Manchester, New Hampshire, because the cost of business under Massachusetts with Maura Healey's record of failure, you literally see the cost of business in this state is just simply too high. The taxes are too high, and that there is an onerous regulatory environment in the state that is just a complete mess, and it has made our economy into a mess. Instead of spending money on that, instead of providing the dollar bills back that we need, do you understand that if they spent money responsibly, if we had fiscal responsibility on Beacon Hill, we would have more dollar bills to spend on our local communities and to spend on our schools and hospital and healthcare and education and all this stuff. You know, all the stuff that Maura Healey claims that she wants to spend money on, but there's no way that she's going to pay for it. It's all smoke and mirrors. Everything that she claims that she wants to do is all smoke and mirrors. Well, there's a structural deficit that you have caused. Well, the one reason that you have caused it is because of your 4% surtax on income over $1 million that is going to negatively affect people, obviously, at the lower end of the income scale. It's not going to affect billionaires. It's only going to affect small entrepreneurial businesses and affect middle-class taxpayers that make $1 million at any point. And guess what that's going to do? That's going to drive a big portion of wealth out of this state. And that's what it's done. And that is what has happened. And it was a bad idea. It was bad for sports teams. It's bad for all of them. And the result of it is, under Maura Healey, now our business climate that was once friendly and was once competitive is now not so friendly anymore. That's literally why that one business, that one local chain restaurant literally said that they should open up their business across the state line up in Manchester, New Hampshire. And guess what? Other businesses that are in this state are probably thinking, wow, what a difference. Man, imagine how much money I'd be saving. Imagine how much money we could be generating and how much our workers could get paid and everything else. See, that is actually caring about the middle class. That's actually the thing to actually care about the middle class. The one thing to actually care about the middle class is to actually make things business friendly. Because Maura Healey's Massachusetts is anything but business friendly. There's an onerous regulatory environment that is so difficult to maneuver. It's always changing. It's like people say, people move to New Hampshire, they move to Maine, they move to Virginia or Delaware or Florida or somewhere like that. They could literally get things done way quicker than they could ever do in this state in months. That they could get things done in months in those states versus years here. It's ridiculous. So you see that and you see all this spending and it's not good. And there's a reason why. Oh, well, but if you look at the other thing, it shows that she cut $375 million in spending. Yeah, because the tax collections are lagging. Because as a result of this structural deficit, she's now spending more money. That's the reality. Charlie Baker shaved $98 million from what was then a $39 billion budget. That is not an opinion. That is not my opinion. That is a fact. Even though I'm a massive fan of Charlie Baker, and I thought he was the greatest governor that this state ever had. We were in a great state when he was in office. It was a great place to live. You know, everything was pretty good overall. It's just the reality of the situation is that when you have an inhospitable business climate, do you understand that is bad for the middle class? Because everybody is working class, right? If we're all working class and we work for this group, this organization, this and that, how do you expect the organization to operate when there's all this red tape, all these inhospitable regulations and run regulation on top of regulation on top of regulation. How do they expect that to happen? How do they expect those people to actually thrive and make money? How do they expect to make money and how do they expect to thrive? How does our quality of life? How do they expect to have a good quality of life when their businesses can't get ahead and they can't do things within years that businesses in other states, from New Hampshire to Delaware and so many other more business-friendly states, can literally get done in months compared to years that they can here. And all the operating costs are too high in this state as well, because Maura Healey is going to end up taxing the businesses. And understand that taxing businesses is actually bad for the middle class. That's not a progressive way to do things. When you're choking small businesses and you're choking the middle class, how is that progressive in any way? Oh, that's right, it's not. But you got these so-called Democrats and these so-called progressives that try to act like, oh, well, that's progressive, that is so progressive and everything. No, it's not. The reality of the situation is it's simply not. There is nothing good about it. And spending all this money is a terrible idea. It is a terrible idea, and it's going to result in an even bigger deficit. It's going to result in hiking the deficit or having to hike taxes or record local taxes like Maura Healey wants, and that's before she wants another $9 billion more dollars to pay for all her new spending. Folks, we need to actually shame spending. We need to shame spending and actually put that money back into our economy. That's what we need to do. That's what we should have done, and that's what needs to be done. In order to get this state moving again, that's the only way we're going to get. That's the only way. And we need to do that before Maura Healey bankrupts what is left of the state. Because the result of Maura Healey's record high local taxes and increasing spending by $57 billion, up 7.4% compared to the previous 2 years, it's just crushing our economy. It cost us 3,211 businesses. Caused 5,000 people to be unemployed within the first year. That's a 5,000 job loss increase. And the fact that wages are stagnant and our tax climate ranks 46th out of 50 states. Folks, that's simply unacceptable. And if I was in office, I would do everything the complete opposite of what Maura Healey's done over the last year and a half. We don't want another 4 years or another 8 years of what we've had for the next 18, over what we've had for the last 18 months. We don't. I simply don't. That's the reason, and there's nothing good about it. There is nothing good about any of this. And I'm gonna keep talking about it. No, look, I'm gonna keep on hammering about it because this state is home. This is a state that I've grown up in my entire life. This is a state I was born in. This is a state that I love. And when I see that this state is off track and it's not in a good place, I'm going to speak out about it. Because it's about our future. This is literally about our future. This is not just my typical, political video that I make about my opinion. No, this is about the future of my state. This is about the future of the state that I live in. This is a state that I love. This is a state that I've been born and raised in. Okay, so that's the reality of the situation. The reality of the situation is we have to look at Maura Healey's record and show that her record has been nothing but a failure. Her record has been nothing but job losses, business losses, and taxpayers losing taxpayers at an alarming rate. Our business climate is inhospitable. Our tax climate is inhospitable. Taxing people too much, taxing businesses too much, and all these inhospitable regulatory environments in this state has to change. The tax climate has to change. And leadership on Beacon Hill is desperately needed, because I'll tell you, we do not have leadership on Beacon Hill. That I can assure you. That I most certainly can assure you of. And fun fact, while this state has slumped in tax climate, guess where New Hampshire ranks? They rank number one in this region. Did you know that? Did you know that New Hampshire ranks number one in the region and number sixth overall? And guess where we rank? We rank 46th out of 50 states. Is that acceptable? Do you think that that's going to be good for the middle class? Is that good for the middle class? We are 46 out of 50 states. You even got others. Even our neighbor Rhode Island beats us. Hawaii beats us. Vermont beats us. Minnesota beats us. Maryland beats us. The only other states that are doing worse than us is Connecticut, California, New York, and New Jersey. That means four other states, only four other states in the country, have a more inhospitable tax climate than this state does right now. Is that good for our future? No, because you see the other states that are cleaning our clocks. You literally see the other states that are cleaning our clocks. New Hampshire ranks number 6th. And the rest is history. So, and then if you look at the numbers here, as I think I might have shown earlier here. Yeah, she's calling for $3.7 million more dollars in new spending. It's just, yeah, that's just completely ridiculous. Folks, I'm telling you, stuff has to change. Our next door neighbor, New Hampshire, is beating us in every single way imaginable. Their business climate, their economy, their record on almost everything, their quality of life, their business climate ranking, everything. New Hampshire is beating us in almost every single measure. Because the governor there, Chris Sununu, was able to balance budgets. He never increased taxes by one penny. Never did any of these ridiculous local taxes. There's not all this red tape in New Hampshire where you have to do this, got to do that, blah, 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 blah. The difference is they're better than us in every way. And it's not good for this state. This state needs to be a regional partner to be good. Because guess what? When Massachusetts thrives, all the other states are thriving. But guess what? We're not thriving. We're not moving in a good direction. And that needs to change. But it's not going to as long as we've got this. I don't know. I just, oh my God, I'm just. What is so good about that? I don't understand this. Because that's all the Democrats believe in nowadays. That's why I don't trust them, and I won't. That's why I don't trust them, and I won't. The choice for New Hampshire is what they've already got. They've had no new taxes, and their economy is doing better than anybody in this region. But I'm not jealous of that. I think it's good for them because that's what? They built a good model for themselves. They have built a good model for themselves. They're a state that they should look up to. And guess what? They're a state that everyone else is looking up to. And I'm going to say it. And I don't care how unpopular it is. Oh, no, no. That's not me over here acting like, oh, well, you know. It's not me over here acting like, oh, well, you know. It's like, because I hate this state or whatever. No, it's like, no, it's the fact that I love the state and I want the state to do better. If I actually didn't care about the state, I would want the state to be in the disaster that it's in and want Maura Healey to be governor. I care about this state. If I didn't care about this state, I would just want Maura Healey to be governor and destroy what we got left of this state. Lily's Fresh Pasta is moving to New Hampshire. Why? High taxes and red tape made it too tough to do business in Mass. And that's the playbook Joyce Craig in New Hampshire wants to copy. Yeah, that's exactly what she wants to copy, obviously. That's why. That's why you got Chris Sununu and Kelly out. They are literally a train that is not going to be stopped. They're a train that's not going to be stopped. And they're right about every damn thing that they've said. They are right about every damn thing that they said. And if I was ever governor, I would do the exact same thing. I would actually balance a budget that actually reduces spending and puts money back into people's pockets, and we get more money in people's pockets. Where guess what? Less taxes, less all these regulations that are so ridiculous. That would actually result in better wages for people. where not all this ridiculous amount of money is taken out of your check every time and all these regulatory environments that you have to do. Like, this is the reason why that business, that Lily's Fresh Pasta, and literally, like, look at them. You will literally see it. Just take a look at it right there. Look at it. These are the owners that are speaking. That's Kelly Ayotte right there, and that's Chris Sununu. They're speaking with each other. They're all speaking there about what they want to do there. You know why? Because New Hampshire is doing better than us. Because New Hampshire is better as a state in every way, shape, and form. That's why. Because they're doing just the complete opposite of what's doing here, of what's going on here. They have great local control over their tax dollars. Their tax dollars flow, you know, that they literally flow. Where it injects more money into small businesses and more money in their pockets. That's the reality. The New Hampshire advantage is literally there. It's there. And you see it. Unless you're not paying attention, but hey, it's there. Man, I would do the complete opposite of what's been going on here. And we have to look at the record. That is the difference between there and here. But me, I'm going to stay in the state and I'm going to fight. Because I want this state to be better. Because I want to make this state a better place. And I'm going to keep speaking out on it. And I'm going to speak out about it. I'm going to speak on how I feel. And I want to make the state of Massachusetts that is affordable and transparent. And is better off economically, politically, and diplomatically and everything. I want this state to be a better place. I simply do. I want this state to be a partner with our neighbors in the region, with New Hampshire, Maine, and others, and we can all thrive together. And that's what I want. I want unity. I want class. I want unity. Middle class unity. That's what I want, and that's what I'm advocating for. And that's the exact thing that I want. And that's what I want. And that's the future that I want for this state. And if we did, we'd be so much better off than we are now. And I am embarrassed by the direction that the state is in. I just think that this state could be so much better. I think the state could be so much better. Because New Hampshire is doing better than us. Maine's doing better than us. Vermont's doing better than us. Virginia, Delaware, and Ohio, and other different places, they're all doing better than us. All the states that have less taxes have more money for themselves. The money, the ones that don't tax you on everything. Because it seems like everything's being taxed nowadays. It's like you're being taxed to breathe nowadays. Something that these partisan Democrats on Beacon Hill and in other places that do the exact same thing, they don't seem to. The other ones that do this in those states, in Massachusetts and in other states that do the exact same thing, they don't seem to grasp nowadays. It's not like they care. They've never had a. Do you think that they've ever had a struggle a day in their life? No. They've never had a struggle a day in their life. They've never had to struggle to keep the lights on, to keep their business thriving. They've never had to struggle. They've never had to struggle like that. We need people that we can relate to, leaders that we can actually relate to. And that's the reason why Chris Sununu was such a great governor in New Hampshire. And I have confidence that Kelly Ayotte, despite my disagreements with her on certain issues, for sure, I'm confident that she will continue that legacy. And I'm confident in that. And I want Massachusetts to be a better place because this state is not moving in the right direction. It's moving in the complete opposite direction. Maura Healey's running the state into the ground. She's running our tax climate, business climate, political reputation, and everything. Just running it into the ground. It's not going to be good for our state economically, politically, or diplomatically over the long term. And it's got to change. Because Maura Healey has never met a tax hike or a fee hike that she didn't love and hiked. And all the other Democrats that are on Beacon Hill right now, including her fucking idiot Lieutenant Governor Kim Driscoll, Kim Dumbass, never met a tax hike or an inhospitable regulatory environment that they didn't love or didn't support in Massachusetts and beyond. They've all supported tax hikes and fee hikes and bad policies their entire life, everywhere in the world, wherever they've gone, their entire life of being on this earth. And that's not people that we can relate to in this state. And that's something that's got to change. And we need to get these people out of office and repair the state and make the state into a better state that we can be proud of. And if I was governor, I'd do the exact opposite of what's been done. I would cut spending, get tax cuts out the door, real tax cuts. I'd roll the sales and income tax more to a more competitive level. I would roll them back to like the levels of like Maine or some more moderate state or something. You know, this state used to be more moderate. When Charlie Baker was in office, this state was a moderate blue state. Now, the direction that Maura Healey wants to take us in, she literally wants to take us down the direction that other inhospitable states are in. California, New York, New Jersey. They're losing more taxpayers than us. But guess what? That's the direction that she's going to take us in if we don't get serious and get these people out of office. If we don't get these people out of office, that's the direction. That's the road that this state is going down. The people of this state need to understand that. And I think more people are. The people of this state do not like the direction the state is heading, and they acknowledge that taxes are too high. I literally say it. That this is something I see on Facebook, I see it on Twitter/X, I see it on Instagram, I see people saying this stuff about Maura Healey every single day. It's not only people from Boston, people from the North Shore. It's Southern Massachusetts. It's the South Shore, the North Shore. It's Western Mass. It's Central Mass. People feel a huge disconnect in this state. They don't feel like politicians are listening to their concerns, and they don't like the direction that the state is heading in, and they're concerned about it. They see how New Hampshire is doing so much better than us. That's why New Hampshire is the place to be. That's why people are all moving there. That's why people are moving there. That's why people are moving to less taxed states. We can still be a Democrat state and be better off as a state. Just look at Delaware. Delaware is a solid blue state, and they are one of the least taxed, most business-friendly states in the country. Why can't we be like that? I don't know. Maybe Democrats in Delaware just think differently. Maybe that's this. I don't know, man. Maybe they just think differently. Maybe Democrats there just think differently. But Democrats on Beacon Hill, no such luck. All we can do is speak up, vote right in the 2026 election, and get Maura Healey out of office sooner rather than later. Because within the next decade, I don't know where the state will be heading. So, I don't know. If Maura Healey in office, this state's not going to be in a good place. It's already not in a good place, but it's gonna get worse before it gets better. Unless we get serious now and get her out of office. That's the only way we can do it. The solution is get rid of Maura Healey and Kim Driscoll and get someone that can actually bring real bipartisan change and solutions to the problems that we're facing. If I was governor, that is exactly what I would do. Even if I ran as a Green Party member, I would balance things. I would be a voice of bipartisanship on Beacon Hill. I would still be a Green Party. I'd be Green Party, but I wouldn't be raising taxes. I'd be doing the opposite. I'd be cutting taxes. I would be doing things completely different. I'd be balancing a better budget. I believe in the environment. I believe in going green 100%. But when it comes to taxes and fees and regulations, I think we got to do better on that. And that's, if I was ever governor, that's what I would do. So anyway, I'm going to wrap this up here because this video was longer than I intended. I know I was kind of going on for a bit, but anyway. So anyway, I'm just going to leave it for here because that's pretty much all I want to say on this. So yeah, I did the numbers. The numbers did add up. The numbers are there for sure. I mean, it's literally right there. So anyway, I'll be back tonight, 7 p.m., around 7:15, 7:30, around the same time. So I'll catch you, comrades, in the next one. Until next time, and including my stream tonight. So more stuff on the way. Stay tuned. Stay well. Stay classy. Keep fighting. Keep up the good fight. Keep on rocking. And I'll see you, comrades, in the next one. Take care of yourselves and all of each other. And I will continue to speak out here about the problems here in my state. And I want to make Massachusetts a better state for all. I want to make Massachusetts a better state for all, including for my family and for others. Anyways, peace. Have a good day. See you all in the next one. So long.